Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today I want to show you how I make these amazing, delicious brown butter chocolate chip cookies full of chocolate. Yes, you are seeing that right. These are so delicious. Now, I don't have to tell you. Just look at that. Oops. Yeah, it fell, but oh well. Yummy. So if you want to learn how to make these, stay tuned and I will show you how. These are the ingredients that we are going to need for our brown butter chocolate chip cookies. To start with, we are going to be needing 3 cups of all-purpose flour, 3/4 cup of regular sugar, 3/4 cup of light brown sugar, 2 tablespoons of cornstarch, 1 teaspoon salt, 2 teaspoons of vanilla, 2 bars of unsalted butter at room temperature, 2 large eggs at room temperature also, 3/4 cup of chocolate chips, 3/4 cup of chocolate chunks. I'll be using these chunks. And I have milk chocolate and semi-sweet chocolate mixed in here, and I'll be using both of those. Now let's get started. You want to start to heat up your pan on a medium. You don't want to go any higher than medium heat because then you will burn your butter and you do not want that. I have mine at a medium and all we're going to do is keep stirring this until it melts, and we want to start to see like a foamy texture. As you can see, we've got that foam already. And now we're just going to continue to stir this. Do not stop stirring this. Don't look away. Just stay here and keep stirring this until we get that brown color. Keep stirring. Now you can still see the bubbles here, but once you turn off the heat, you can start seeing that brown come through. Meaning you've got your brown butter. There it is. And now, so it doesn't continue cooking, I'm going to put it in a bowl. And that will ensure that this stops cooking. That is what you want. And just to show you what it looks like, there's your brown butter. And we want to let this cool at least 10 minutes. In this bowl, I'm going to add in my 3 cups of flour. And I am leveling it out, meaning I'm putting the flour here and then leveling it out. 3 cups. 2 tablespoons of cornstarch, which I will also level out. 1 teaspoon baking soda. And 1 teaspoon salt. Mix that together. And set aside. And now that this butter has cooled down, I'm going to add that to our bowl, along with our sugar, which is 3/4 cup regular sugar, and 3/4 cup light brown sugar. And you can do this with a stand mixer, or I'm just going to be using my cordless hand mixer. Now go in the eggs and the vanilla and incorporate that together. I'm going to do half at a time and just with this wooden spoon, I'm going to mix that up. Add the rest of the flour. And once you've got that, we're gonna fold in our chocolate chips. This recipe calls for 3/4 cup of the chips and 3/4 cup of the chunks. And we're just going to fold that in. Make sure that you have preheated your oven to 350 degrees. And I'll be using this ice cream scoop. Once I scooped it on here, what I'm gonna do is grab it and then just form it into a ball. This. And then just mash it a little bit. And same with this. And I'm going to add a little bit more of this on top. And these are ready for the oven, and you're going to do 11 to 12 minutes just until they look puffy and just very barely golden. Do not overbake these cookies. These cookies will cook even after you think that they're not. They will finish setting as they cool. So I am going to place these in the oven. These are done and these are going into the oven. Remember, 11 to 12 minutes just until lightly brownish here. You don't want to over bake these. These came out of the oven. Yum, this has so much chocolate. I made me a little one here. And let's open it up. Oh, wow. Ooh, look at all that. So much chocolate. If you don't like so much chocolate chips, just don't add that much, but we love them here. This is the next batch that I took out, and what you can do, I have some sea salt here. If you want that sweet and salty, as soon as it comes out of the oven, you're going to sprinkle some of this salt on here. And there is your sweet and salty cookie. Just remember that the sea salt added to this is optional, but I will be leaving some just with no salt, but I will have some of these with salt because I like it, but my kids don't like it. So these are going to be mine. And my last batch is out of the oven. These are amazing. You need to try them, seriously. Now we're gonna get another one. See how nice and golden it is from the bottom. Yummy, look at that. Okay, well, that's it. I hope you make them. And if you do, leave a nice comment down below. Don't forget to subscribe if you have not already been subscribed to my channel. Don't forget to click that like button, share my video, leave a nice comment. Thank you all for watching. See you next time. Bye.